Okay, here's another bulldog. We'll get the face of him. Started off, already got a couple circles down. Kind of building up that shape. Keeping it kind of loose, finding that egghead nose, and then just stretching that out to meet the new snout. Gets that part going. Find the center line. Sketch that in there. So just kind of blocking it out nice and light. Find the ear. Other side's wrapped around it in perspective. There's just the side of his head like a cheekbone. Big cheek, baggy cheeks there. That looked pretty good. And on the other side of the nose, just kind of building the crease there, find the center line of the nose. Tapers down. There's the lip. So the center line goes all the way down the front, cuts through the lip, and then right down into the other jowl. And find a center line for the chin, right about there. Three-quarter view, kind of all in perspective. Tips that section up. And exaggerate all the form there. Nose there. Nicely put up. Couple more cheek lines. Kind of puts that in there. Lower mouth. Eyebrow. Right where the eyebrows are going to meet. Kind of has that, always that furrow. Try to give it some dimension under the eyeball, tucking it in there, baggy eyes. Putting the ears in there, looking good. Fold it over a little bit. Showing the creases. Another big eyebrow. Eyeball coming out there. So you just tuck on that in there. The cheek lines just add effect and emphasis. It's always kind of helps you put a pupil in here. Give the characters a scary look to it. Pretty good. Emphasizing the wrinkles with the shadow. So keeping the lines going with the form. It really makes a difference there. Coming up on there. That's always good. And the jaw helps you make the line up there for the collar. Color almost becomes part of the anatomy. Kind of frames, almost like he's in a frame on the wall. Like a deer head. A little bit. And it's all pretty loose drawing all the way through. They start doing the final lines. Placing that in there is good. Let the teeth kind of just get the basic shape. You always three-dimensionalize it as you go. Underlip helps emphasize the shape. Fix some of the jollies. Bottom part of the eyes there, nice and shadowy. Size the eyebrow. Good, you have a highlight in the eye. Lightens it up a bit. Pretty much have it. The spikes just put a line to get started. Same thing as a gesture. Line of action, so to speak. Helps you space them. That's ellipticize all of them. Put the tangent line in there real quick. The bottom one's good. Slap them in there. Heavy him up and put some finesse into it later. Specs for the whiskers. That's what he looks like so far. Now just heavy up. Some of these lines just pick a spot. And this is where you have the thin and the thick idea, same as with pen and ink. Only now with pencil. Place that on him. Helps your memory too, putting this in there, all your visual connection memory for all the drawings that you'll do. Furrow in the eye, there you go. Get a little more of an iris on there. Shadow under the eye. Bags under the eye, shadows with the eyebrow. Put a little texture in there. Almost a sculptural feel to it, three-dimensional, trying to really build that up. All those shapes in there. The shading in there. Embellishment on the color. sometimes the initial line you can leave as a base tone. Just make it bigger. Quickly drawn stuff. Highlight shadows in the nose. The other cheek just, and always draw through the item so your proportion stays good. Everything comes together there, so it's all bunched up in there. Just doing a little bit on the collar. There's a point right there where you can leave that line, or put it in there ahead of time, and bolden it up there, trap it. Off the page a little bit. It's always fun. And all these lines trying to wrap it around. That's the direction the collar's going. So if you leave it like that, the shapes and negative space it creates helps wrap around the drawing there. Another piece in there. Kind of block it in for now. Lay it out there. Looking good. Put your shadows on the lighter side of it too, just side of your pencil. Go with the direction of the form, leave a little base tone highlight. You always shade some of it just lightly, just to separate them.